faithful Niner Empire. What's good? You know who it is. It's your boy, Jay in the Bay. It's the moment we've all been waiting for, a faithful playoff time, and the 49ers are meeting up with an old rival in them good old Dallas Cowboys in Texas. Now let's preview the game. Let's get it. The Cowboys have had a pretty good regular season. They won 12 games, and they won their division in the NFC East. 49ers and Cowboys have rich history, two historic franchises of the NFL. We know they've had their battles in the 70s, the 80s, and the 90s, but we really haven't seen the Niners and Cowboys play in the playoffs since like 94, 95. So this definitely is a pleasant sight to see. The 49ers and Cowboys will meet up again. And there's no doubt this Cowboys team is loaded with offensive talent, starting at quarterback with Dak. They got two solid running backs. They got wide receivers. They got a good tight end. This is a pretty good Dallas Cowboys offense. They also, they're not too shabby on defense either. They got Micah Parsons, who will probably win the Defensive Rookie of the Year. They also have Trayvon Diggs. He leads the NFL in interceptions. So this is a talented matchup. The Dallas Cowboys and the 49ers, I think they match up pretty well, but I think there will be some advantages that the 49ers will have over them Cowboys. The 49ers will win this game. One thing we need to do is we need to force the Dallas Cowboys offense to be one-dimensional. We know the Cowboys want to run the ball with Zeke the Freak and Tony Pollard, but I don't think Zeke is the same running back he was, you know, in his first 3 to 5 years. I don't think he'll be much of a difference maker in this game. Now, Tony Pollard, he can be a difference maker. He's got speed. He's got power. But this 49ers run defense has been doing a pretty good job over the last 2 months. We've only allowed about 3.2 yards per carry. And this usually forces offenses to have to throw the ball, to move the ball down the field. So number one, stop the run, make their offense one-dimensional. And then that'll let our pass rushers go after the quarterback. Faithful. Y'all know the 49ers want to run the ball, whether it's Deebo Samuel, whether it's Elijah Mitchell. I think those will be the two main ball carriers in this game. This is who Shanahan trusts the most, and the 49ers need to establish the run. The Cowboys, they're solid in the running game, but I think the 49ers will have some advantages based on the pre-snap motion that the 49ers do. And also, we just know how to run the ball. We know how to spot a defense's weakness. At least Shanahan, that's one of his specialties. And the 49ers have been able to, I wouldn't say neutralize, but they've been able to not allow the defense's best player to really have a career game. And I think that's what will happen with Micah Parsons. Yeah, he's young, he's talented, he's a beast. I'm glad we're meeting him in his rookie season because, you know, maybe 3 to 4 years down the line, he'll be, one of the best in the NFL. And he's almost there now. But the 49ers will need to run the ball, control the clock, win the time of possession. If we do that, this will definitely be a victory Sunday. One thing I noticed about them good old Dallas Cowboys, they do lead the league in penalties. Now, clearly this hasn't affected them in the regular season, but in the playoffs where every play counts and you're playing the upper echelon talent in the NFL, I think this will rear its ugly head in today's game. So the Cowboys, they do lead the league in penalties. And for the 49ers, we do need to play disciplined football, not have any excessive penalties, not have any turnovers. We did have some penalties last week, but if we keep those to a minimum and we play clean football and let the Cowboys have penalties, this will definitely work in our favor. Dallas Cowboys have some playmakers at the wide receiver position. This will be an interesting matchup for our secondary. Our secondary has dealt with injuries. At one point in the season, I should say for weeks out of the season, we had Josh Norman starting at cornerback. But I don't think he will get much playing time, at least in defensive snaps in this game. I expect Emmanuel Mosley and Ambry Thomas and also Kawan Williams to be the three starting cornerbacks. And I think that will put us in the best position to defend these Cowboys wide receivers. And I think we are healthiest at this moment in the season. We're getting a lot of guys back. Trent Williams is expected to play. Also, several other players on the defensive side of the ball are expected to play. So we're meeting the Cowboys strength versus strength, and we can't allow the Cowboys wide receivers to get behind us and make big plays. Just keep everything in front and contain these wide receivers. Faithful. This game is won and lost in the trenches. the best part of the 49ers defense, or most productive part of the defense, is the D line and the pressure we're able to get on opposing quarterbacks, and also in slowing down the run. This defense has been much better in the last 2 months in slowing down the run and getting after the quarterback. Nick Bosa leads the team with 15 and a half sacks. We're getting production from Eric Armstead, DJ Jones, Arden Key. We can easily go, you know, 6 to 10 in depth in our defensive line. So I think that will be the difference in this game. The 49ers will get after Dak, make the offense one-dimensional. And I think we should be bringing Dak to the ground several times. And also on the other side of the ball, we're going to have to protect Jimmy G, make sure he has a clean pocket to throw from, and then also make sure we open holes in the running game. Niner Empire. We do these five things, I can see the 49ers advancing to the next round of the playoffs. But there's no doubt this is a talented Dallas Cowboys team. I don't think we can go down again 17-0 and come back against this team. Hopefully that's not the case. Hopefully we get off to a good start. Also, what's very important is, you know, third down conversion. The Dallas Cowboys offense has been pretty good in third down conversions in the last, I would say, month or so. But also you have to look at their competition. They haven't really played anyone. I mean, they're in the NFC East, one of the worst divisions in the NFL. I don't think they've played a talented team on both sides of the ball like the San Francisco 49ers, who are playing some of their best football. So I like the 49ers to win in this game. Obviously, we got to, you know, make sure we play clean football, win on third down, and win the time of possession. If we do these things, I think the Niners can win this game. I got the 49ers winning 34-27. Faithful, what do you guys think of my prediction? Make sure you leave your thoughts in them comments. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Go Niners.